Women behind Mo3 death speaks on his passing, IG Live.
The life I live, I see a killing, I won't say a thing. Except the witness on a mission, he won't say my name.
Dallas rapper Mo3 emerged from the city's north side with an unflinching and honest snapshot of street life. His booming flows and slow-burning style, met with streetwise lyrics on projects like 2017's Four Indictments, got the attention of millions of fans. Mo3's extreme talent even caught the attention of Boozy Badass. This man had a whole career and a bright future ahead of him, all taken in an instant. Now the woman behind his fatal passing speaks out on Instagram Live for the whole world to see. Welcome to Lime Report. Today, we'll be telling you everything you need to know about this situation one detail at a time, so be sure to pay close attention. Before we get into this video, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and comment keyword Dallas for a chance at winning our giveaway. Now back to the video. Mo3 was born Melvin Noble in 1992. His rap debut came in the form of his 2014 mixtape, Shot Us. Following his mixtape came a solid local following and a deal with his idol, Texan rapper Boozy Badass. The sequel to his debut, Shot Us Reloaded, arrived at the close of 2015. The album featured Hold Your Tongue, which went on to become a moderate hit for Mo3, notching nearly 2 million streaming views in the year after its release. Reloaded hit number 14 on the Billboard rap chart, climbing to number 2 on the Heatseekers chart. His follow-up, Four Indictments, appeared in late 2016 and topped the Heatseekers chart early the following year. He also issued the Gangsta Love Part 1 mixtape in 2017. Mo3's 2018 project, Shot Us 3.0, would include one of his biggest hits yet, the cautionary Everybody, which also racked up millions in streaming numbers. The next year found Mo3 mainly releasing singles, including the sample No Feelings and the stormy Too Much Pride. In February 2020, he teamed with Boozy for the collaborative mixtape Badass Mo3. The project quickly entered the Billboard 200 chart at number 136. Around noon on November 11th, Mo3 was driving on the Interstate 35E near Illinois Avenue and Clarendon Drive when the fatal incident occurred. Photos released by police showed an armed man wearing a black long-sleeve shirt and jeans get out of a Chevy Camaro and chase 28-year-old rapper out of his car and then down the road on foot. Both Mo3 and a bystander were hit. The bystander was transported to a local hospital with non-life-threatening injuries. Mo3 was sadly pronounced deceased at the hospital. Now police have suspect Kaywon Dontrell White under custody right now, but how did Kaywon know of Mo3's whereabouts? So many details to this murder are not revealed, but rumors have spread that Mo3 was set up. And set up by who other than two of his mistresses. Mo3 was seen leaving one of the women's houses when the black Chevy Camaro of Kaywon White started following them all the way to the highway. The streets talk, and now these two women have a bounty on their heads for setting Mo3 up. They were even accused by Mo3's baby mamas, and now the two women take it to Instagram Live, where they came out and addressed the situation. They try to hide their guilt, and in doing so, reveal more evidence that they were the ones behind the murder. "His baby mama only accused me because they're bitter," claimed one of the two women. She even started the live by already dissing Mo3, saying he was not close to his fans. Hate comments filled the live, and the only thing they could do was give unclear answers and block accounts. She stated, "People really be snakes nowadays. It's the people closest to you you gotta watch out for." This was her cover-up for giving away the information that Mo3 was at their house. It was all a coordinated plan, and she just revealed it live on Instagram. Mo3 was also rumored to have beef with these women's new partners, and this was all that was needed for the fans and loyal followers to put two and two together. Mo3's second mistress turned off the live after the other woman's slip-up due to everyone watching catching on. Death threats and address leaks flooded the live, and now the streets of Dallas are on the brink of war. Kaywon, who's in police custody now, has major ties to Yella Breezy and Trap Boy Freddy, who are also tied up to these two women. Many people think Kaywon's going to snitch, and these two will be taken care of by the police soon for what they did. Being an ex-partner of Mo3, police have already labeled her as a prime person of interest or a suspect in the crime. That's not enough for some of Mo3's most loyal fans, though. People who have followed the rapper since his come-up are not satisfied, and this little incident on Instagram Live only added more fuel to the fire. Gang members loyal to Mo3 are soon taking action themselves, and it's a great thing society believes in equality, because they will not hold back when they come face to face with every single person responsible for Mo3's murder, these two women very much being one of those people. Big-time real estate mogul Jordan Aubrey describes the issue as being careful on what properties you buy in the Dallas area, as the streets of South Dallas have transformed into a war zone following the death of Mo3. People are afraid to walk the streets in fear of being shot and killed. People are also afraid of being caught in a crossfire between the people responsible for the 28-year-old rapper's passing and his avengers. There is not enough police to keep the situation handled in the South Dallas area, and if Mo3's murderers are not arrested, they're slowly starting to find themselves in the same situation as Mo3. The only question is, when will the mastermind of this ambush find herself in a coffin as well? That's all for this video. Thanks for sticking to the end. Make sure to leave a comment, keyword Dallas, for a chance at winning our giveaway. See you next time at Lime Report.